The Big Rab Show Podcast is kindly sponsored by G1 Reeds. They are the champion's choice, with many bands around the world playing G1 products, providing everything you'd need to hit the circle or the big stage. So check out g1reeds.com as they keep the lights on here at the Big Rab Show Podcast. Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another Big Rab Show podcast. How yous doing, folks? Hope you're all keeping rightly out there in podcast land. Yep, you guessed it, another week has rolled round in the bagpiping world, and strap yourselves in. We have a special episode for you this week. Now, yeah, I know whenever we say special episodes, that disappoints some people out there, but we're doing it for a good reason. This week we're bringing you all of our coverage from the St Laurence O'Toole Inspired in Aberdeen concert that happened this past weekend. Can we tell you just what an incredible show it was? So, if you haven't been following us on our socials, of course, or even on YouTube and all of that, you probably have missed out. So, go along, check out those recordings. They're all up there now. You can go and have a watch at them. But I have to say, not all of them have been published as of yet. Anyway, we'll get into all of that. But first of all, let's get through our introductions then, shall we? Well, if this is your first ever Big Rab Show podcast, then you are welcome. We are the show for the bagpiping folk, reflecting everything in the bagpiping world, be it Celtic music, folk music, or indeed our bread and butter, competitive piping and drumming. Each and every week we're here talking about what we know and love to be the music of the great Highland bagpipe and its people. And, yeah, we're going to talk about Patreon in a little bit here. I feel probably most of the show will be dedicated to that, but we'll get into the rest of it. Each and every show, we do open our doors to listener mail, and this week, unfortunately, we'll not have any listener mail, but that will be brought forward to next week's show. All right, because this is a special episode, we don't have any of our usual features. We don't have Weekly Drone, for example, we don't have listener mail, and we won't have Dates for Your Diary. All of that will be returning next week, folks. This week, we are definitely dedicating a full episode to the St. Laurence O'Toole concert. Now, so, that mailbox is always open, however, so please do get your commentary into us. Any questions, queries, or things you want read out on the show, absolutely. Email us in, bigrabshow@gmail.com. That address again, bigrabshow@gmail.com. Let us know your thoughts on everything happening in the piping scene right now, and yeah, we'll bring it here to next week's show. All right, let's talk about Ravara, first of all. Yeah, so before we get into everything about St. Laurence O'Toole, I do want to talk about Ravara. Ravara Pipe Band had a concert this past weekend as well in the Island Arts Centre in Lisburn, and by all accounts, everything I've heard from the concert has been nothing but a glowing review. Unfortunately, I did have plans to attend and cover everything from the Ravara show, but personal circumstances intervened, and I was unable to attend in the evening. So that's why I say, unfortunately, I was unable to attend the Ravara concert. Now, I was absolutely gutted as a result, but however, sometimes life catches up with you, and yeah, I just couldn't attend it. So my apologies to everyone there at Ravara Pipe Band, and of course to the podcast listeners who were expecting a whole ton of stuff from the Ravara show, but unfortunately, I couldn't make it. That's on me. So I have to say, right now on the show, full apologies to everyone at the Ravara Pipe Band, but I have seen little clips and little photographs of stuff from the concert itself, and the reviews that I've been getting from a lot of folk from around the piping scene who were there told me, Rab, where were you? You missed one heck of a show, pal. So that's on me. Again, I have to give a full apology that I did not manage to attend, but this was one of those occasions where, yeah, real life caught up with me and prevented me from attending an event. So, one of those things, folks. Sorry. There you are. So, yeah, that's why this week's episode is all dedicated to the St. Laurence O'Toole show. Because Stuart Campbell, member of the Rab Show team, managed to travel to Aberdeen and cover the entire show, both from a soundcheck perspective and also from the actual concert perspective itself. So, we're about to get into all of it here. But before we do, let's take a little break, and we'll be right back. Do you you wish piping could be fun again? Bagpipers around the world continue to struggle with their instrument, despite hours of hard work trying to get better. Bagpiping should be fulfilling. Your hard work should pay off, showing improvement and the freedom to express yourself musically. Or why do it? The Dojo University believe every piper should be able to free themselves from musical frustration, proven over more than a decade of successful teaching and accessible anywhere with an internet connection. The Dojo is unlike any other bagpipe learning experience in the world. Let the Dojo channel your enthusiasm into a fun and fulfilling program that will empower you with the knowledge to fall in love with piping all over again. So go to dojouniversity.com/bigrab and take advantage of our 30-day free trial of Dojo Premium Membership. Join the global community of students today and rediscover the fun of bagpiping. dojouniversity.com/bigrab for a 30-day free trial. Wallace Bagpipes. Quality, pride and passion. Made in Scotland. Proud bagpipe supplier to the Red Hot Chili Pipers. Visit wallacebagpipes.com for more information or contact your nearest dealer. And we're back. Now, before we get into everything about our coverage from the St Laurence O'Toole concert, I do have to mention a few things. Bucksburn and Dist kindly invited us and the Rab Show team to go and attend the concert and cover every aspect possible. They even invited Stuart to attend the sound check. And as the band were preparing and getting ready for the concert, Stuart was there with a camera and managed to film a whole lot of really cool backstagey stuff showing the preparations for such a huge concert. And, all of that backstage-y, exclusive soundcheck-y stuff will be available to our Patreon audience. Oh! There you go. So if you would like to help support the show, then you can head over there to Patreon, click on support, and you'll get your mitts on all of these extras once they're finished. Yeah, once I finally get them all edited, I guess, because Stuart literally filmed that much. There's loads here. Anyway, so that'll all hit the light of day over there on Patreon. All right. So also that goes for the recordings from the concert itself. If you do want to get exclusive access to those ahead of everybody else, then go over to Patreon, have a look at them over there. That's where they live. So if you do want to get them, click support and you'll get your mitts on all of the extras. And then eventually they will see the light of day over on our YouTube channel. But right now we're dedicating a full show to the concert, including some recordings. So strap yourselves in. We've got some really great music to share with you. St Laurence O'Toole Inspired. We did speak to their pipe sergeant, Brendan Murphy, of course, in our previous podcast as he talked about the preparation for this big concert and what it meant to the pipe band to be doing this. And as you'll hear, the band have certainly found form and at a very early stage. So yeah, this is the tail end of April. And as you're about to hear, St Laurence O'Toole are certainly not sitting on their hands. They are absolutely sounding incredible here. So let's get into it. This is our coverage then from St Laurence O'Toole Inspired in Aberdeen, courtesy of Bucksburn and Dist Pipe Band. And the band sounded incredible.
Thank you.
straight into this week's topic of the week with Crazy Frazee. That's how the show started. And yeah, that we've managed to capture quite a bit from this show, all thanks to, well, Rab Show team member Stuart Campbell, who was there. Stuart, how did you find the show, man?
The show was excellent. It's fantastic. The music was just incredible.
Aye. Oh, well, that, as you just heard, that was the kickoff of the show, good and proper. But you were there for a good part of the day, like doing a lot of like backstagey kind of stuff, seeing the band prepare for things. How did you find them during soundcheck? You know, was it furious and frantic, or were they quite chilled out?
A few of them were running about, trying to get things sorted, going back and forward to the sound guy. We were able to sit right in front of the stage to have a listen. And there was a couple of folk just running back and forward, getting, obviously, they wanted the perfect sound for the concert.
Yeah, yeah, there you go. So you were very much backstage for us at the Rab Show team. So I have to say thank you, first of all, that, for doing all of that. But in a way, it's weird. You know, you get like this access, but it's like having your own personal concert. You know, like during soundcheck, the band would play this thundering big tune and then there's no applause. It's a bit weird, isn't it?
Yeah. There was a few folk for the Bucksburn pipe band there. You got the occasional clap and a cheer, but not the full seated area, you know, everybody clapping and cheering. No.
That's it. So I'm sure a very different atmosphere for the show itself. Yeah. Now, obviously, you're a snare drummer with the mighty Onningston. Yo, Onningston! I have to give him a shout. So how did you find things then, even watching it from a drumming perspective? You know, watching Stephen and the guys do their thing?
I find that the level on the grade one, it's the dedication that these guys put in. Obviously, what people don't see in the background is 2-3 nights a week practice and the hard work that you put in just to see a 3 or 4 minute performance MSR or a medley, but at a concert, again, the amount of tunes that you have to remember, it's incredible.
Absolutely, and all from memory, not a sheet of music anywhere. And I know we spoke to the pipe sergeant before about this, but it was, he put it in so no uncertain terms that it gave them a kick up the back end to have something to prepare for, you know, ahead of the season. It seems to be that is exactly what happened here. Yeah.
The band sounded fantastic. It's, again, there was a small interview that I recorded that you did on stage. It says it does give you the kickstart to start your season on the best foot. Than going into your first contest going, well, we could maybe change, you know, tweak this and tweak that. This is, you do that now before you hit the grass. So they're very, very well prepared.
Absolutely. Well, I think we'll hear a little bit of that interview actually that was done on stage. So this was Kevin from the Chili Pipers, isn't that right? He was compere on the night and he decided to have a chat with Alan Tully, isn't that right?
Yeah, he did on the stage.
There you go. So we'll hear a little clip from that now.
Tell you what, I'm glad he's the one sweating, because it's normally me that's up here sweating, so he's going to feel it tonight, ladies and gentlemen. So, in preparation for this, Alan, what went into this?
Well, I suppose the objective of this concert for us was to really get the band ready and prepared for the upcoming season. So the key thing for us was to make sure that we were together as frequently as we could be as a full band, make sure we get the season off in the best possible start. So we've a lot of preparation, a lot of work done already, so hopefully it sounds like that.
Definitely does on my end, ladies and gentlemen, for your end. Yeah. A couple of last questions before we head on to the next set. Now, how do you deal as a band? Because obviously St Laurence O'Toole are a famous band throughout the world, and a lot of players aspire to be in the band, but not everybody lives in Dublin. So how do you deal with players that are international and want to come and play with the band and make sure that you have that consistency of sound and quality, technique, performance? How do you deal with that as a pipe major, both before your dad and obviously with yourself?
Well, I think with top-level grade one bands, it's the size of the band up until recently has been quite important, but it's, I think for most of the bands at the top, the nucleus of players is not there to sustain the band of our size. So we've got 6 flying players this year. 5 of them based in Scotland and 1 in Denmark. So the Scottish bass players, they practice every week, same as us in Dublin. So that's important that them as a group that they can get regular practice time. We split the harmonies to make sure that there's also harmonies in Scotland as well, so that they're used to the overall ensemble by the time they step into the band. So there's nothing new to them. And for anybody else who's further afield, they just need to be top level players. They need to be able to be on the money and walk into a core that's very well rehearsed. We also see them quite frequently. So
talking in front of quite a packed audience there, like the hall itself was really, really busy. Was that your impression?
Yeah, the venue was almost sold out. There was a couple of empty seats, but the venue was packed. It was packed.
There you go. So, and yourself now, for those of you who have managed to see the little video clips that we have up on YouTube currently, you got yourself in quite a good spot. Was that done deliberately? Did you know Bucksburn set you up, or?
Well, I'd asked during the sound check, where do you want me? And they said, we've got you a couple of tickets. But I hadn't seen the tickets, so I didn't know where the seats were.
Yeah.
But when I got to the venue, they gave me the tickets, and it was up in the balcony seats. So we were above the floor, so we could look down onto the stage.
Mm.
Yeah, it was a perfect seat, because you were directly in front of the stage.
There you go.
It was way back in the stands.
That's it. But your camera had a zoom lens on it, so we're fine. but I have to say, I know this is from my experience. And I know someone might disagree with me, but if you're going to a pipe band concert, I wouldn't normally sit on the floor. I would try and get up high so I get both, you know, the drones and the chanter. Because if you're sitting on the floor, you maybe just hear predominantly chanter. But where you are up in the balcony there, you got a real good mix of both, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. It's good to get the above the sound, if you know what I mean, because you're up above the stage. But when we sat down, set my camera up, and the one thing I didn't want to do was get in anybody's way.
Yeah.
So that I wasn't distracting anybody. So we sat down.
Here's that big Rab guy getting in the road. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So myself and Chloe, we set our camera up. And about 2 minutes before the concert started, there was nobody in front of us, nobody behind us. 2 minutes in, two folks sat in front of me. So it was we looked to our right, and there was a couple of empty seats, and there was nobody in front, nobody behind. So we quickly shuffled along the camera, set up again, and away we went.
There you are. So shout out to those two folks who sat in front of you then, made you move.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, here, I'm going to deliberately play a set here at this point. We're going to play a few more clips of music from the show, but this one, I don't know, it's kind of a favourite now for St Laurence fans, but the Donegal Lass set. This is definitely one of their signature tunes. Yeah, so here they are. Here's the Donegal Lass set.
Thank you.
Stuart, listening to that, and you can definitely tell that they have a new bass drummer at the helm there. You know, it's not John. You can really hear it there. But at the same time, Paul is definitely making that instrument his own there, I think. You know, he's developing his own voice there.
Yeah, he's taking it on board, obviously. He's got big shoes to fill. And he's put his own voice on it.
Aye.
To fit in with the St Laurence O'Toole sound. But yeah, he's doing a really, really good job.
It's a very difficult task, as we were saying, you know, because John has been such a part of St Laurence for the longest time. You know, we're used to that St Laurence touch that he has. So now it's just brilliant to see what Paul's bringing there, for sure. Did you get a chance at any stage to chat to anybody out of St Laurence bands at all throughout the process?
I did, but like I said earlier on at the sound check, there was a few folk that I wanted to speak to. I was like, hello, I'm Stuart from the Rab Show. Hello. And then they disappeared again. So I was like, okay.
They ran off on you. All right.
They were really, really busy during the day. So I didn't want to intrude too much because obviously there's folk under pressure trying to get the concert set up and get things
That's
right.
It. So yeah, there's work to do for sure. Yeah. So well, there was a set that was played here that you've captured a video of. Now, we haven't put this up yet on our YouTube channel. We don't know whether we will or not, but it's the track called Little Bird. Do you remember this being played on the night? How did you find that?
Yeah, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful tune. Mm. Absolutely beautiful. It's Chloe, my daughter, helps me out. It's her very, very first concert that she's ever been to.
And
that was one of the tunes she said, wow, that's a pretty sweet tune.
It was definitely a moment for sure. So, right, let's have it on the pod then this week, eh? So here we are. Here's the track, Little Bird. Thank you. Wow, so that was quite an introduction then for Chloe to hear a set like that played at her first concert. What was her impression afterwards? You know, did she give you a review?
She was kind of like, wow. Although she's quite new to the pipe bands. She's only been playing a couple of seasons. And so she's never experienced a concert. And for her to experience a first concert at St Laurence O'Toole, you can't get any better than that.
That was superb, yeah. So I don't know, like, this incoming season is going to be a very competitive year. You know, here in Northern Ireland, we heard People's Forward playing at the Kids with Cancer Night. That had everybody talking. But now that we're seeing clips now from St Laurence in concert, that equally has got everybody talking, I believe. Yeah, so I don't know. Your impressions for this incoming year, positive or negative for St Laurence, Stuart? What do you reckon?
Very positive, very, very positive. I think they've taken the reins and they've went with it. You know, like you said, they've done all the preparation, so they're very, very well prepared for the incoming season.
Absolutely. Their drum corps is singing, and I think tone-wise, piping-wise, they're certainly there. They've definitely found their tone early this year, for sure. So, but one thing I wanted to talk about, and we did play that earlier on, they played the Donegal Lass medley, which is one of their, you know, signature tunes. But also, they've been referring back to a lot of their signature tunes as a result of this concert. You know, a lot of the big hits, as they've mentioned. And of course, one of the tunes that we haven't heard played in concert now for a long time, The Dawning of the Day. This is kind of very much a signature tune of St Laurence. And I think even in the recording of your video here, Stuart, you heard the crowd almost singing along with it.
Yeah, it's a fantastic tune. I've only heard it as a recording, so that was my first
hearing
of it live. And it kind of makes the hairs in the back of your neck stand up a wee bit. It's one of those tunes that really, really gets to you.
There you go. We'll have to hear it now. So here it is. Here's St Laurence O'Toole and Dawning of the Day. Thank you. You know, Stuart, you're not wrong. That is one of those sets that no matter how many times you hear it, it still does kind of give you the chills. Especially for me, it's the introduction. Do you know what I mean? It's whenever they strike up with the solo piper and he's really flourishing there and then everyone joins him. That's when it kicks in for me. That, oh, yeah, it's so good.
It's a pretty special tune.
Absolutely. Well, I know another set that'll have a lot of people very happy to hear return again to the repertoire is, of course, the Pumpkins Fancy. This is a tune that was, I don't know, it was synonymous with St. Laurence. And again, they haven't played it in the longest time. But again, Stuart, hearing this live, especially as a drummer, what was your thoughts on this?
I'm a drummer. I've got a drumming ear, so I'd listen to the drumming. But it's one of the tunes you sit back and go, right, I need to listen to the tune. I need to listen how it all fits together. It's pretty special.
That's it, because you're bound to have heard hundreds of pipers playing it over the years at house parties and stuff like that. You know, it's normally when there's like 12 pints in, let's play the Pumpkins Fancy.
Yeah, no,
but it's whenever you hear it played so well by a grade one band that it really hits home. So let's hear it. Here's the Pumpkins Fancy set. We'll be right back. So, Stuart, part of the night then, obviously, it wasn't all focused on St Laurence O'Toole. Obviously, that's, you know, what we've been listening to up until now. But I do want to give a shout out to Bucksburn and District, who were the hosts on the night. So, first of all, did they take care of you?
They did. My first meeting point was Gus. Totally looked after me, showed me around. Even in the backstage, there was a room set out that had sandwiches, drinks, coffee, tea.
Oh, here! You were fed and watered as well?
Yeah, he says, just go and help yourself. It's not a problem.
So, that's amazing.
Very well looked after.
Oh, shout out to Bucksburn. Well, not only that were they hosting us on the Rab Show there to be there, but they were also on stage as well. So tell me about the performances then from them. And there's one in particular that we really want to highlight here.
It's Absent Friends.
That's the one, yeah. So Bucksburn and District, their novice juvenile band, took to stage. And they had this really amazing dedication, I guess, to members who had passed. And so tell us about this tune then. Whenever they performed this on the night, what was the reaction?
It was a kind of somber moment. They were remembering that past playing members and past members of the band. A couple of youngsters started off, two of them played, and then the rest of the band came in with the tune Absent Friends.
There you go. So we'll have to hear it at this point, yeah. So here they are. Here's Bucksburn and District. Stuart, quite a poignant moment in the show there, you know, give people opportunity to pause and reflect, you know, for, you know, friends no longer with us. And such a great moment as well to have the novice juvenile band doing that. You know, I'm sure they could have easily asked St Laurence O'Toole to do something similar and say, here, could you guys play, you know, a slow air piece or something like a suite like that. But it was awesome that the hosts themselves done that. And yeah, the kids seem to be up for it, you know.
Absolutely, I think they had a great time on stage. They played their match set, competition set, and they played was it a 3-4 set that they played? So they played a couple of sets,
There you
and
go.
the joy in their face that they thoroughly enjoyed it being on the stage.
That's it. Yeah. Any feedback that I've heard so far about the appearance of Bucksburn was overwhelmingly positive. About so many folk were saying, this is so cool to see all of these junior players on there thumping out the big tunes with the big guns. It was brilliant. So speaking of big guns, let's bring it right back to the feature act on the night, St Laurence O'Toole. And again, I have to say, one of my particular favorite sets, and this is the reason I've left it to this point, is of course the Biggin Medley. Man, I love this set. So, Stuart, what did you think about it yourself whenever you heard it?
It's one of these sets that you're like, wow. It's the way they've put the tunes together and the way they present it. It's just like you're like, wow, well, that's pretty special again. It's it's really
Absolutely.
good.
And it's one of those things at a concert like this, you're constantly getting punched in the face with amazing music. It's difficult to take in sometimes, but let's have a listen to it. Here they are, St Laurence O'Toole and the Biggin set.
Thank you.
You know, the big set there, it's one of those, I don't know, man. I completely agree with you. Whenever you listen to something like that, you kind of do find yourself lost for words.
Yeah, it's just a wow set. Wow.
It is. That's definitely one of their big sets for me, for sure. And I don't know, I'm definitely going to be talking as a drummer at this point. I know I'm a wannabe piper now, but there's something about Stephen Crichton's drum corps in that set particularly. There's something that they're doing that's just magic in there. I don't know what it is.
I can't pinpoint it either. There's lots of quiet, but lots of loud.
Yeah.
Lots of loud, lots of punch. But there's lots of quiet.
That's it. There's that dynamic range, absolutely. But rhythmically as well, like there's times there where they're really driving things, you know, and you almost get the impression that they're all clinging on. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Hang on.
Yeah, hang on. We'll get to the end of the part. But man, it's so enjoyable to listen to. And I have no doubt that those players there in that band have fun playing this stuff. You know, and I think that really comes across as well. And in a previous interview, we were chatting to People's Forward guys, and they were talking about playing for enjoyment as well as playing for competition. And I think St Laurence is definitely one of those bands that, you know, really focus on the enjoyment of the music here. Do you think that come across in their concert?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It's again, they're all, although they're up on that stage for over 2 hours, They looked as if they enjoyed it.
Yeah.
They looked as if they're putting enjoyment into the playing and into the music. So
that's it. Yeah. They certainly didn't look too grumpy anyway, that's for sure.
No.
Yeah. So we're coming up to the final couple of pieces now where they play the finale here. So this is a quite special moment then for Bucksburn and District Novice Juvenile Band. They took to the stage and joined St Laurence O'Toole on stage. That's bound to have been a special moment for them there.
Yeah, they did. They packed the stage out and got the kids involved. Again, the kids with huge smiles on their faces, you know, thoroughly enjoying the moment up there on the stage with St Laurence.
Oh, for sure. So they kicked things off with a 6-8, first of all, and then at the very end, I think they did an encore then of Scotland the Brave.
Scotland the Brave, yeah.
Yeah, so let's get a listen to that finale then.
Yeah.
Stuart, there you go. That was the end of the concert. Now, we didn't play every single track, I have to say, because the concert itself is over, what, 2.5 hours long?
Yeah.
Something like that?
2.5 hours, yeah.
Which, as you said earlier, like, that's a long time to be on stage piping and drumming. You'd be wrecked.
I don't know how they do it, to be honest. Obviously, there's a mental side to it there. You're up there playing a concert, so you've got to play your best, and it's got to be the best every set, you know, because there's folk here looking at you, you know. But they've done a fantastic job. Yeah, they've done a fantastic job.
Absolutely, yeah. And Stuart, I know I'm going to blow your head up, nothing rotten here, but you've done a fantastic job in covering all of this for us, I have to say. Thank you. So, running about backstage, if you do want to catch all those backstage videos, by the way, of which I don't know how many hours worth of stuff you managed to get for us, Stuart, but there's a lot. I've got a bit of editing to do. But that'll be available for our Patreon subs. Plus, we have a lot of stuff published on our YouTube channel now, thanks to Stuart. And yeah, just keep your eyes peeled over the next few weeks. A lot of it will be reaching Patreon first for early access, but then hopefully in the later weeks and months, we'll be releasing it in general release for everyone over there on YouTube. So go and check it out. So Stuart, I don't know, I'm going to ask you a bit of a dopey question that doesn't often get asked here, but being a Rab Show team member and going to an event like this, was it a good experience or just really stressful?
After my disaster at Sanker, there was a wee bit of pressure on myself to make sure I got things right.
What happened there, full disclosure, is you were there at that competition, filmed a whole pile of bands, and then realised none of the sound was working.
None of it worked. That was down to my mistake. But we learn by our mistakes. So
there you go.
I tried to sit back and enjoy the music, although I was filming, trying to make sure things were right. But I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I'm pretty sure my daughter thoroughly enjoyed it as well.
Yeah, shout out to Chloe. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So at any of these kind of big events that we try to cover, as much as it may come across that we're volunteering and we're working at these things, it's also really cool to get this access and to have that opportunity. Yeah, we get to hear some blistering tunes sometimes. Yeah.
During the sound, I didn't know where to go. They said, you can go anywhere you want. So I was like,
yeah. Where do I stand? Yeah.
Where do I start? Where do I go? So I did my best.
Oh, you've done a cracking job. And folks over on Patreon can go and check out all that sound check stuff. It was really interesting. Yeah. To see the work behind the scenes. If anything, I might have took liberties. Whenever they done Tourist Call Resume, here in Northern Ireland, and they told me, Rab, you can film everywhere. I was very cheeky. I joined them on stage. I got up there with a camera and filmed the drum corps right next to them. I'm sure they were ready to kick me.
I thought about it and I was like, they did say I could go anywhere, but I'm thinking, I don't want to be pointing a camera in somebody's face. And they go,
right in their face. Yeah, imagine standing right next to Alan Tully and like filming him like 2 inches from his nose. Yeah, no, that's it. There's definitely a happy medium. You know, we're competitive players. We know what it's like, you know, trying to concentrate and do a performance, and then to have some idiot sticking a camera in your face is the last thing you want to see. So no, we have that experience. We know what it's like. So we definitely, yeah, remove ourselves from that if we can. Yeah. So there you go. What a fantastic show. I have to give a huge shout out to Bucksburn and District. And of course, to St Laurence O'Toole for having us here on the Big Rab Show team to cover things. Yeah, such a fantastic evening. Have any parting thoughts then, Stuart, on the whole thing?
When's the next one?
That's a very good question. One? Yeah, I have no idea. But we're heading out of concert season now. And I suppose we're heading into competition season now. From filming on a nice, comfortable balcony to filming out in the lashing rain somewhere. That'll be us now over the next few months. But Stuart, thanks a million, mate, for covering all of this for us. And that's it for another topic of the week. Thanks a million.
Thanks, Rob.
you have it. That was our coverage from St Laurence O'Toole Inspired in Aberdeen. There you go. I have to say a huge thank you to Bucksburn and District for having us there, of course, and a massive shout out to everyone there at St Laurence O'Toole Pipe Band, of course. We're very happy for us to have cameras all around the place. And again, I have to give a huge shout out to Stuart. What an incredible legend for giving up his weekend and, yeah, frantically trying to film everything that moves. So as I've said, all of those videos will be across Patreon initially, but we'll eventually see the light of day over there on YouTube. There you go. All right, so hope you've enjoyed this week's pod. It's filled with music. And that last set there, actually, was called the Miss Sarah Moan Hornpipe Set. There you go. So, bright times ahead for St Laurence O'Toole. And, if anything, bright times ahead for our competitive scene, I would argue. As we just mentioned, it's going to be a very competitive year. And I cannot wait for 2024. I've got that, yeah, in my calendar for sure. The first competition, I cannot wait. Anyway. So, this has definitely been a podcast of a difference, but one that's been a lot of fun to put together. So, we hope you've managed to enjoy this week's episode, and yes, next week, normal service will resume. We will be playing catch-up, we'll have, of course, weekly drone, listener mail, all that usual stuff. That'll be all on next week's podcast. Alright? So, if you're here expecting dates for your diary, then that'll be next week. Alright? So, again, thank you all for downloading this week and each and every week. And don't forget to tell your mates about our wee show. And as we mentioned at the very beginning, there has never been a better time to sign up for Patreon. Yeah, if you do want to get exclusive access to all of those videos from the St. Laurence O'Toole gig and, of course, the backstagey stuff, then, yeah, head over to Patreon. Consider clicking on support and you get your mitts and all of that goodness. Anyway, that's it for another episode. And we will see you here back again next week for another podcast filled with bagpiping goodness. Until then, folks, we'll see you all next week. All the best. Well, that's it for another Big Rab Show podcast. Thanks so much for downloading this week. And a special thank you to our sponsor, G1 Reeds. Played by bands around the world, they are the champion's choice. Check out g1reeds.com for all of your piping needs. Don't forget to check out thebigrabshow.com to be kept up to date with all of the latest news and views from around the piping world. And also, check us out on Patreon. For $5 a month, you can get your hands on tons of extra piping goodness and be a part of the Patreon faithful. So, until next week, folks, we'll see you right here on the Big Rab Show podcast. All the best. We'll